Hello Brick fans, we're back, this time with our recreational vehicle, our RV, but this isn't just your any old standard RV. Tell us why, Joe.
Just imagine you need to go into the desert and do some sciencey, experimenty stuff, and you basically got two options. Either you buy a very expensive mobile lab, state-of-the-art with isolation stuff and explosive-proof and bomb-proof and everything else, or you go for a dilapidated, older style of RV, which you can buy from a used car lot and then modify to make a lab out of it.
So, tell us what you think you'd do, because we know which one we chose. Option number two.
Because it's cheaper. Yes, exactly.
Exactly right. Let's show you why. Let's pop the roof off. Then here, we'll put this to the side.
And since you can look better from the top down, if we remove the awning, is it an awning? Is it a shade?
It's a shade. Let's just shade.
You can
shade.
Just there remove that. Yeah, and then you can have a better look at the inside. And as you can see, there's a lot of sciencey equipment.
We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cauldrons, I'd call them.
I think there's stuff for distilling. Maybe you need to extract some special chemicals from the soil.
Maybe. You might be doing a geographic experiments.
Definitely.
I studied geography.
You studied geography? Yes. Have you ever worked in an RV like that?
No. I also quit after 2 semesters.
Because you were afraid you'd have to work in an RV
exactly,
like that?
Exactly. I did. Although I do enjoy trips in RVs, I've got lots of fun stories. But, so this is a mobile lab. This isn't anything to do with a normal RV. There's no bed back here, no sitting area, no cupboard or a fridge or shower or anything. This is purely for
science.
Science.
Definitely science.
All right. So what do we have here? Of course, here we have the distillery stuff. Mm-hmm. And then we have the workbenches here.
Yeah. You've got the gas bottles down here. I can maybe show you. I'll just flip it a little bit. You've got the gas bottles here, the distillery equipment down here. And on the other side, you got the workbench. With a fan because it gets hot in the desert and a lot of stuff. You even got a little bit of underfloor storage if you need to. Not sure if you can open it.
Yes.
You can open it. Some underfloor storage if you need to
hide some spare cash for when you go on a Taco Bell run.
I don't actually think it's spare cash. It might be just some scrubs.
That's
you know,
true
laboratory
as well.
Clothing, because you do not want to get that stuff anywhere on your real clothes.
Exactly.
And, of course, you've got a lot of boxes and lots of little details.
Exactly. I do like the details.
Yeah.
Where's the Petri dish? This one, you mean?
Yeah.
Ah, yes.
And you even got a syringe in case you got bitten by a venomous snake.
Yes.
I never got what is the difference between venomous and poisonous?
If it's venomous and it bites you, you die. If it's poisonous and you bite it, you die.
Ah!
So,
okay.
Let's say something is poisonous,
yeah.
You have to ingest it to die.
Ah.
But if something is venomous, it just has to bite you so that you die.
Okay, so basically if you eat a snake, it's both venomous and poisonous.
No, because that wouldn't kill you. Well, I don't know.
Depends on the snake you eat.
Depends, but yeah, if you eat a poisonous toad, it'll kill you.
Definitely. Not a good way to go.
Exactly. What else do we have here? I like the little sidelines of here, of the colours on the, like, what? That's kind of pastel-y pink.
I think it's medium nougat.
Medium nougat.
You might know it from skin colour from some minifigures, or it's also oftenly used as a colour for wood.
Oh, okay.
And down there you got the yellow and the orange and the dark brown.
Okay.
Also in the tent. It's a very 70s vibe, isn't it?
Very, very 70s. So, what else can we see here at the front? We've got, I'll show the detail camera now, the place where you can at least drive it. One would hope that when the chemist or the science man or science woman drives this into the desert, they can still drive it back out again. So obviously that's where you sit.
Down below you've got lots of little cabinets which you can open to find some stuff inside. There you go. And,
So there are lots of little hidden nooks and crannies in here, which I like, because it shows that the designer really thought of loads of details. I mean, look at this. This is alone six little different
cabinets.
cabinets on the outside that are all filled with various different things. You've got a compressor here, a fridge or a safe, some water, ropes and everything. We shall certainly show you.
Put it into the detail camera.
Oh, there we go. Check it out. Shall we tip it a little bit? We tip it, can you see? Might be covering up one thing. But then we can tip it and you can see all the little extra added details in there, which is quite impressive. Because you've got to think, when you build this, they have to go in first and then you build the rest of it. So the designer really thought of absolutely everything on this set,
that
I think.
Did.
Because on this side as well, you have 6 cabinets.
And a lot of
even
stuff.
More. So more things to add in there.
But generally speaking, we can't really show you all the details because some of them are built down so deep into the body that you have to build it to see it.
Exactly. Which is, I mean, the whole fun in it all.
Definitely, that
it is. I did another video recently where on the German channel where Ollie said that you could put some lights in to hollow spaces and then it would be like an interesting, well, lamp. Do you think you could do that here? Because we've got lots of windows here as well, which illuminate everything. So if you flap up the these wind or curtain-y type things here and then put a light in, you could have a very interesting type of lamp.
Yeah, but even I think it would work best with a light blue color from light.
Yeah, light blue. Yeah. That would be cool. Put a few LED strips in. Perfect. So yes, this is our RV, of course, with the sail and everything. So you can use it. I mean, if you really want, you can just take out the lamp and add your own things in there. That's also possible.
That's the great thing about bricks. You can build whatever you want with it.
Exactly. So if you think this is a cool base build, but you don't like the lamp, hey, that's your decision. What you want to do with your own RV. Let us know in the comments for you to put other stuff in there or other things you'd make your RV look like. Because I think there are quite a few options.
Yeah, definitely.
And then make it into a 70s vibe. You could add this into a 70s series. I don't know. Little diorama. Big one. Now that's nice.
Big one, definitely.
But, yes. Also, a nice reminder for maybe a holiday that you did in your younger years with your family. I don't know. I think the set has quite a few options, not just as a mobile lab, but as, well, anything you really want it to be, because that's what bricks can be.
Exactly. And you can never have enough bricks.
So, have fun building.
And what's stopping you from getting more?
So see you next time.
And thank you for watching.
Goodbye.